I certainly want to share your very gracious applause with all of the members of the Los Angeles Philharmonic Orchestra and with some of the guest musicians from our TV organization and with their director, my brother George. I think they're deserving of a special hand just for themselves. Speaking of our organization, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to point out one thing. There are some gentlemen up here that look like they got the wrong instructions on what to wear. Well, they're dressed that way on purpose, see, because it makes it a little easier for me to introduce them to you. They're the members of our TV group, and I'd like to take a few moments to have you get better acquainted with them. First of all, George, have you got some get acquainted music? A little something? Oh, I like that. That's good. Wally, we're going to start with you. Here's a gentleman we discovered up in San Francisco. He was the musical director at the Curran Theater for the Judy Garland and Betty Hutton shows, and we're very, very proud to have him with us. He's a graduate of the Juilliard School of Music, and his name is Walter Borzella. Take a bow, Walter. Nice to have you with us. And our principal second violinist is a very distinguished gentleman named Mr. Boardman. And the amusing thing about Mr. Boardman is that we always refer to him as Dad. He's just like a father to us. And I happen to know that he voted for Eisenhower, and his first name is Truman. Take a bow, Truman. Well, we're very, very proud that we have such good-looking guys in our group. Wally, particularly, he does all of the acting parts in our TV show whenever I do some kind of a romantic type song. Wally usually makes love to some beautiful girl in the background. See, that's part of his job, and he enjoys that very much. He's a very romantic type, Wally is. And after giving him that big romantic buildup, I hate to spoil it for you, Wally, but Walter happens to have two children, and he's married. Now, you know what I'd like to hear, George? I'd like to hear how all of the strings would sound together with Wally and Dad, okay? Wonderful. Isn't that nice? And now I'd like you to meet a young man who does things in a real big way, and I guess maybe that's the reason he chose for his instrument the bass violin. We're very, very proud to have him with us because he formerly was featured with Harry James and his orchestra, and we're thrilled that he came to play for us for the same money. Mr. Bob Manners, have you got a solo in there, Bob? Okay, let's hear it. Now, I'd like you to meet the youngest member of our organization. He's just a boy, but he has a very illustrious musical background. He has appeared with Ray Anthony's orchestra, Ralph Flanagan's orchestra, Freddie Martin's orchestra, and he has a very important sounding name to go with his background. His name is Norbert Liederbach, but we call him Nobby for short. And he plays the trumpet out of this world. Listen to Nobby. Wonderful, Nobby. And now I'd like you to meet our drummer boy. He's a very talented young man, and also a great businessman. He's the creator of some wonderful and entertaining animated TV commercials that are on some of the leading shows. And his name is Robert Sandy. And right now, I'd like you to hear him play his wonderful style of drums. Play for his brother. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to introduce to you a gentleman that has appeared with many of the major symphony orchestras throughout the country, most recently with the Indianapolis Symphony. But his fame is not only attained through his classical playing, but the fact that he has mastered the difficult art of playing jazz on a very difficult instrument, the French horn. And as a result, Downbeat and Metronome magazines for the past 4 years have named him America's foremost French horn virtuoso, Mr. John Gras. Terrific, Johnny. Well, we consider ourselves very, very lucky that we have in our group a very lovely and beautiful and talented young lady. She plays 6 different musical instruments, but she looks so very heavenly that we usually find her next to her favorite, the harp. Her name is Marilyn Hecht, and give us a little sample, Marilyn. Pretty, I like that. Thank you very much for Marilyn. Marilyn, may I comment on your beautiful dress? You got that just for the Hollywood Bowl, huh? Gee. That does things for you, that really does. Yeah. Well, let's see now, who do we have? We have one of the original members of the Paul Whiteman Orchestra and the Benny Goodman Orchestra. He's famous for his guitar playing and also for the fact that he brought back into popularity that wonderful sound of the Roaring Twenties, the banjo. I'd like you to meet Alan Roos now as he plays the banjo. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet the man who makes all of the orchestrations that accompany my piano work. Besides that, he is our assistant conductor. He plays second piano. He plays a very wonderful instrument called the celeste. And he is a graduate of the Louisiana State University, where he holds a doctor's degree in music. He is also remembered by many people as the associate conductor under Pasquale Amato of the Metropolitan Opera. We're very proud to have this distinguished musician in our midst, Mr. Gordon Robinson. And right now he's going to play the celeste. Takes care of all of the guest musicians. Would you like to hear George play a little something on the violin? George, play something real schmaltzy now, something real pretty and nice, okay? All right. That's schmaltzy? That's a little ditty Jack Benny taught him. Well, that takes care of everyone now except me. Would you like to hear me?